Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people. Light for the world to see. Christ, be our light. Shine in our heart, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church, gather today.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we begin this season of Advent, we prepare our hearts to welcome the Lord. We ask him to overcome the darkness of our sins and enlighten us with the light of Christ so that we may know forgiveness and peace.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. You, Lord, are our Father. Our Redeemer, you are named forever. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways, and harden our hearts so that we fear you not? Return for the sake of your servants, the tribes of your heritage. Oh, that we would rend the heavens and come down with the mountains quaking before you, while you wrought awesome deeds we could not hope for, such as they had not heard of from of old. No ear has ever heard, nor eye ever seen, any God but you doing such deeds for those who wait for him. Would that you might meet us doing right, that we were mindful of you in our ways. Behold, you are angry, and we are sinful. All of us have become like unclean people. All our good deeds are like polluted rags. We have all withered like leaves, and our guilt carries us away like the wind. There is none who calls upon your name, who rouses himself to cling to you, for you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us up to our guilt. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you are the potter. We are all the work of your hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved. Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved. O Shepherd of Israel, hearken. From your throne upon the cherubim shine forth. Rouse your power and come to save us. Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved. Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine and protect what your right hand has planted. The Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong. Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved. May your help be with the man of your right hand, with the Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong. Then we will no more withdraw from you. Give us new life, and we will call upon your name. Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you were called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Show us, Lord, your love and grant us your
The Lord be with you.
And
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his own work, and orders the gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch, therefore. You do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening or at midnight, or at cockcrow or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all, watch." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Never put off until tomorrow what you can do today. That old proverb fits in well with today's scripture readings. We are challenged to be ready to meet the Lord today. We should not put off being prepared. Almost exactly 12 years ago, a priest friend of mine died suddenly while swimming near Lubang Island in the Philippines. Father Steve was the rector of a seminary in which we lived during our first years in the Philippines. He was an American from Ohio, and we quickly became good friends. We had a lot in common, and we would turn to one another for mutual advice in our roles as leaders of our respective communities. Their community was having an outing in Mindoro during the semester break. He went swimming with two seminarians. He was pulled down by a riptide from below and he drowned. The two seminarians were able to swim to shore. Obviously, Father Steve did not know that he would die that day. In fact, he was an expert swimmer and a trained lifeguard. I would like to think that he was prepared to meet the Lord, but I don't know for sure. I never asked him, and he never told me. Jesus says in today's gospel, "You do not know the day on which the Lord will come. Be on the watch." He wants us to be awake, to be prepared, to be ready. And so we need to ask ourselves an important question. Are we ready to meet the Lord today? Is there something we need to do before we are ready? If so, don't put it off till tomorrow. Do it today. Think of the various areas of your life. Concerning your relationship with the Lord, is there something you've been meaning to do to strengthen your relationship with the Lord? Do you want to be more faithful in your prayer life? Do you want to make the Lord more a part of your daily life? Do you want a more personal relationship with the Lord? Do it today. Concerning your family life, what have you been meaning to do to strengthen your family life? Have you wanted to spend more time together as a family? Is there a broken relationship that needs to be healed? Do you need to forgive your parents for something? Or as a parent, do you need to forgive your children or grandchildren? Do it today. I heard a story recently about a person who was estranged from a family member. There was a major disagreement, and a rift occurred. She remained angry at her family member for a long time, but eventually her heart began to soften. She began to think that it was more important to be reconciled than to carry a grudge. Unfortunately, the family member had become sick and lapsed into a coma. She went to the bedside of her relative and whispered her words in the ear of her family member. She wasn't sure the message was heard. Perhaps she waited too long. Never put off until tomorrow what you can do today. Another area of life where we may want to make some changes is the workplace or the places where we do business. Are there changes you want to make in the way you deal with other people? Do you need to be more honest, more courteous, more charitable, more patient, or so on? If so, do it today. Never put off until tomorrow what you can do today. And what about you, students? Do you need to be kinder to your classmates or more respectful to your teachers? Do you need to be more tolerant of those who are different from you? Do you want to stop picking on certain people and making them the object of your jokes? If you know you should, then do it now. The message of today's readings is simple and to the point. Do it now. Do not put off making the necessary changes. Make them today. Tomorrow may be too late. We can profess our faith, praying, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. With trust and confidence, we bring our petitions before the Lord, the God of mercy.
For the church, held close by the Shepherd of Israel, that all will be open to receiving God's merciful love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are entrusted with positions of leadership, that they may govern with wisdom, prudence, and compassion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and their families, friends, and caregivers, that they know God's healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the children of the world, that they will be safe, fed, housed, and loved, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this worshiping community, that we rouse ourselves to cling to God this Advent, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the spiritual intentions of E-Grace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Beverly Kearney, Kathy Haralamakis, Father John Donahue, and Joe Smith, and all victims of war and violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We conclude our prayers by blessing our Advent wreath. Will be a reminder to us of Christ who comes as light in the darkness. Lord God, your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth your blessings upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May their light reflect the splendor of Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
The King shall come when morning dawns and light triumphant breaks. When beauty gilds the eastern hills and life to joy awakes, the King shall come when morning and beauty brings. Hail Christ the Lord, thy people pray. Come quickly, King of Kings. Come quickly, King of Kings.
Let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, who is our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise of which now we dare to hope. And so with all the choirs of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your beloved apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Patrick, Saint John Eudes, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family who are gathered here with you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
We pray now for the coming of the reign of God as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit, let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Darkness hangs, the world is aching, yearning for the coming light. In his rising hope awaking, love has come to steal the night. In our hearts, true east we're facing, toward the Christ returned, his word is true.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray, for even now, as we walk amid passing things, You teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
One of the traditions we have during Advent is to celebrate the Sacrament of Reconciliation. Of course, given the current pandemic situation, it is more difficult, and therefore our bishop has given permission for general absolution. During all of the in-person masses, we'll be giving general absolution each of the weekends of the season of Advent. And there will be no Advent penance services anywhere in the diocese this year. But I have recorded an Advent penance service designed to help you prepare for receiving general absolution, or if you're not able to come in person, to at least prepare your heart to receive the Lord's forgiveness. I've been asked the question by a couple people, can I get general absolution during the online masses? And unfortunately, the answer is no. You have to be there to receive individual or general absolution. But this penance service, even if you are not able to come and receive general absolution, would be an excellent way to ask the Lord to give you forgiveness and peace. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.